Like Swamiji said, that we are blessed that this year is his centenary year. He would have been 100 years on May 8th of 2016 if he had been with us. So for us, it is also our seva that we are doing for him to spread what he has given us to as many people as we can. And on that note, we will start our workshop today. The Shishu Vihar training workshop is for all the individuals. It can be, you can be of any walk of life. All that you need is love for children. And that is the main thing. And if you have that, then you can easily become a Shishu Vihar teacher. So starting from here, Pujya Gurudev always told us, children are the architects of the future world. They are the builders of humanity. We all know that whatever comes in the future is going to come from our children. And if we are able to give them the values and the support that they need, then we can be rest assured that we are leaving the world in very safe and wonderful hands. And that is our duty as parents, as teachers, and even as members of society, that we give our children the best that they can, not only materially, but also spiritually. Character building of a nation must start from the cradle. Like Swamiji said, the right time to start is when they are conceived, when they are already alive inside a mother's womb. And the earlier we start, the more benefits we can give them. The pictures that you will keep seeing are all taken from our Shishu Vihar classes that are going on. So the children that you see, they are actually attending classes. Just one thing, that there is a picture there on top, which is Gurudev with a child. And I think that picture has been taken as the logo of Shishu Vihar. I think it encompasses what Shishu Vihar is about. It's all about love, right? So if we give them that, then they are more than happy, and they will come to you whether you want them or not, and then they will never leave you. So that's all that you need to give them. So Shishu Vihar was conceived by Swamini Supriyananji. She is based in Hong Kong, and she is the one who started it in Hong Kong. She is the one who prepares the curriculum. She is the one who guides everybody all around the world on how the classes should be conducted, which includes us. It started around 4 years back, and now with Gurudev's blessings, we have centers all in Hong Kong, Australia, Manila, London, India now. And I just met a Brahmachari ji today outside, and he said, I'm from the US and I have not heard of this. So please make sure that whatever you do, just spread the word and let it start in the US as well. So I've invited him. I said, if you can have some time, please come and join us. We can hear from him also on his experiences. As of today, we have 4 classes that are running in Mumbai. Roma takes 2 of them at Altman Road. Smita Didi Neena Didi take it at Nepensi Road, and Bhavna is taking 1 at Parade. From you all, we hope that the next time we do a workshop, we have like 10 right there, right? So that's what we are hoping and praying for after we finish this workshop. Yeah. So what is Shishu Vihar about? It is about imparting values early. We are increasingly seeing that we have many parents now who come forward on their own, because see, we have also seen that there has been a shift in the way that our society is. Right? Earlier we all used to live with in-laws, all our children had grandparents, they had a big joint family. So there was always some kind of communication happening with everyone. So stories used to be told, everything. Now we have many families who live as nuclear families, your parents and children, grandparents may be living in another city, may sometimes in another country. So parents are now feeling that we want to expose our children to our Indian culture as early as possible. And they are more than happy to take out time, they are more than happy, if they are convinced, they will take out the time and they will come. So we should kind of use that interest to convince them about Shishu Vihar. And as Swamiji said, the children at this age are like sponges. Whatever you say, they will accept. Nobody is going to argue with you. Nobody is going to say, no, how can a monkey set fire to a Lanka? Or how can Ram Bhagwan be bigger than everybody? Nobody is going to ask you. If you will tell them about Bhagwan in a certain way, they will accept it, whatever you say. Which is all the more important that what we say becomes more important, because then there's no one to question you. Nobody is going to say, are you sure? They are going to accept it. So it gives us even a bigger responsibility to be absolutely sure of what we are communicating to them. And the other thing is that even though they have limited responses, they may not be able to talk, they may not be able to write, but they can absorb everything. We have seen that with our children. If we do something wrong, that will be picked up the very next second, even if they are 2 years old. You know, if we say a wrong word, the next word he will utter will, or she will utter will be the wrong word. So they are like sponges. They can, even though they cannot respond, they can get everything into their mind. The Shishu Vihar also involves the family. It is a playgroup kind of a format. It is with the mother and child. When we say mother and child, like Swamiji said, it can be anybody. It can be the father. It can be any family member, right? And the objective in Shishu Vihar is not, like Swamiji said, not for them to learn something and be able to reproduce it. It is not like, you know, like how we have Gita chanting, we have stories we want for our Bal Vihar children. We want them to remember and be able to tell us later on what they have thought. It's not here. Here it is an introduction to God. It is about telling them that there is somebody called God who is your friend, who is with you all the time. And it is some, and he is somebody whom you can love. There is nothing else. There is nothing about what is right, what is wrong, what, you know, did he do the right thing? Did somebody do a bad thing and therefore God punished him? Nothing. The key emotion in a Shishu Vihar is love. That's all. It has to be positive. We stay away from any kind of a negative thought or emotion. It's all about love, and that's the most important thing. So that brings us to the reason why we've talked about why it is different from Bal Vihar, because many of us are Bal Vihar teachers. If you are not teachers, that is the children's class that we have seen or we have heard of, right? What is because Chimya Bal Vihar has been going on for so many years. So first of all, of course, it is a younger age group. We, even in the younger age group, you have two classes, right? You have the infants, which are 0 to 3 years, and then a separate class for 3 to 5 years. We cannot mix the classes because between 0 to 3, the children are very different, and 3 to 5, they are very different. If we try to mix it up, we will not be able to do justice to either of them. Either the older ones will get bored or the younger ones are going to get cranky. So very importantly, and this is something that we all have to follow, it has to be separate. This, therefore, and because they are different, even the syllabus for both the classes, the curriculum is different. Mothers or guardians have to attend the class with their children. When we say guardians, we mean any other family member. You cannot have anyone coming with a domestic help, with a maid, or with any other person except a family member. Please be very strict about it. Even if somebody says, I'm sorry, tomorrow only I have a meeting or I have to go out, can I send him with my maid at home? I'm sorry, no. Please do not bring your child for that class. But at no class can be allowed without a family member accompanying the child. Right? So please be very strict about it. And even if you have to explain to the person, you'll have to explain it. Not even for one class. Yeah. A discipline-free environment. See, at this age, they are young, and they only reciprocate. They will choose if they want to reciprocate to you, right? So you cannot say, come and give me a hug. It's not possible. If they want to give you a hug, they'll come and give you a hug. So it is a discipline-free environment. The children should never be told, don't do this. There is no no's. If at all it is discipline, it is required for the mother or the guardian. No cell phones, no talking in between, right? No, just, you know, walking up and going and leaving your child. No, the mothers or the guardians have to, if they have to be told, it is they who will have to be told, not the children. Let the children know. If the child wants to get up and take a circle in the class, in the middle of the class, let him or her do it. No problem. But the mother should remain seated. The mother should continue doing whatever is being done in the class. Focus on exposure, introduction to God, like we said. Depth of understanding is not required. If you want to tell him about Krishna Bhagwan, you don't have to say he was born in Mathura, then he went to Gokul, then he went to Krishna loved children, he was a naughty boy, he was a mischievous boy, he stole butter, he loved everybody, that's it. We don't need to go into the details of every story. We don't need to go to the details. Like in our Bal Vihar, we will talk about, you know, how does Shivji look? He has. So we will talk in Shishu Vihar, how does he look? But we will not talk about why he has the snake or why he has the moon. We don't go into all that, right? It is an introduction. It is to familiarize them with the concept of our gods in our culture. So how does typically 1 year of a Shishu Vihar class go? It is conducted once a week. The curriculum is basically we spend 1 month on each ward, right? So we have 4 classes. Each class there is a lesson plan. We will come into that later. So there's 1 week, which is one month, which is dedicated to each ward. We celebrate all major festivals. So that is separate from the classes of the gods that you have, right? So if in a month, supposing Janmashtami is coming, then you will have a class where you will celebrate Janmashtami. How with the children, you will do their activities so that they get the significance of what is this day, why is it special, what is, you know, different about it. And these are all the gods that we will cover. Now about, we basically for Shishu Vihar, we take a donation from the parents. We must remember that as a policy, all Chinmay Mission classes are free. They are voluntary. So as a sevika or a sevak, we do it on a voluntary basis. The ashram or the mission does not collect any fees for any class. But we take a donation of 2000 rupees per year, right? Why? Because we take a Shishu Vihar class requires a lot of props, you know, like when you're telling a story, you will need pictures. When you are, see, because for them, they are not going to understand listening so much. For them, visually, what they can see is what they understand, right? So if you are talking about Krishna, they need to have a big picture of Krishna. They cannot think about it in their mind. You need to show them. So all these things, whether it is stories, whether it's songs, whether it is, you know, just an introduction, all of this requires a lot of material that you will have to make. So we, to cover that cost of the material for a whole year, we charge 1500 and 500 rupees is charged as to become a Chinmay Mission member, right? So every year they have to renew their membership. If you have a parent who is already a Chinmay Mission member, then you will not collect that 500 rupees from that parent, right? Then it will be 1500, which is only for the class. But please be sure that you communicate that to the parents. Let them know that Chinmay Mission is a voluntary organization and we take this amount only for the class to be, for the material for the class that has to be ordered. Now once you have collected that from, there is a registration form. Once you all start your classes, you will get all the papers and all the details about it. Once they fill up the registration form, then this amount will have to be deposited with the form to our Church Gate Chinmay Sagar Center, which is at Church Gate. It will go into the mission, and whenever as a teacher you need to you know, make something and you have to submit your bills to the center and you will get reimbursed, right? So that way, that is the policy that will be followed. Any questions so far about anything? Do you have any?
How do you know that the parent would be a member of Chinmay?
You have to ask them. So when supposing a parent comes to you and they are starting the registration process, then you can just ask them that, are you a Chinmay Mission member? See, some of them are, because some of them may already be in the mission for many years and they might want to, but some of them will be new. So if they don't, then they will have a separate amount, and if they are, we will of course trust them on that. No, they're not, you know, we just ask them if you're a mission member or not. The benefits of becoming a mission member, I will just let you know that also. See, when you enroll as a mission member, we have a Chinmay Sandesh magazine that goes monthly to every mission member. So in that way, they will get acquainted by what is Chinmay Mission doing other than Shishu Vihar also, right? So because the Chinmay Sandesh magazine has all the details from all the centers, what is happening, the events, any lectures are happening, whatever is happening in Chinmay Mission. So it gives them the advantage of knowing what is happening. And they can, if they so wish, they can get involved in other things as well, if they have the time. Any other questions?
2,000, right?
2,000.
A year.
Inclusive of the 500.
Yes, inclusive of the 500. If they are already mission members, it will be 1500.
So Shishu Vihar registration is 1500. 500 the Chinmay Mission. So like she said, if you are already a member, the mother is already a member, the parents are already a member, then you take only 1500.
Radhika, also point out that when they make any expenses, the bills that they are to collect, they have to be proper bills with VAT.
Yes.
So, yeah. No little notelets,
yeah.
You know.
So you get your proper bills, like which are, you know, like proper printed bills with, like she, like Meena said, with VAT written down. Either they have those disclaimers written down. So not that koi parchi mein you wrote it and he, the stationery wala wrote it and gave it to you.
Yeah.
Because that is not, that is not recognized as a bill.
Yes.
Proper valid bill. No matter how small the amount is, but get a valid bill.
Let them put that, you know, because then we say, oh, they'll put that 40% tax on it. Let them
put it.
That is the system.
Because there are lots of stationery shops will not tell you, you know, okay, you want to.
They give estimates actually.
Yes.
No. So that,
yeah,
is not,
so that will not be
that is what I'm just trying to.
No, no.
It is not allowed.
No.
No.
Not allowed, not accepted.
Yeah.
You won't get your money then from the mission.
And the year is a period of 12 months from the date of joining, or it's a fixed year?
Well,
say,
normally I
say
think
Diwali
we start from summer vacation.
Yeah, normally it starts, it's June to June. But for example, you get someone in September. So then it is up to
proportion.
You to keep a track that ex mother paid in September, so the next September she pays. Obviously, we'll take it annually. That's how it is.
See, normally what we have found with experience is that, see, 2000 rupees is not a big amount,
yeah, exactly.
Right? So even if somebody has joined like for 6 months, normally they will not have an issue. You know, like they will not tell you ki abhi next September. We've never come across somebody who has been so, you know, like minutely saying ki nahi ab main, I will pay you only next September. So maybe the first year is a little half year, maybe 7 years, 7 months, 8 months. But then for the year after that, streamline it.
But there will be people who join.
Yeah.
You always do. So just, I would write it down that this X person has paid in September. So the next September, it's up to you to give a reminder if the child is not already due for Bal Vihar. Because see, then they move on. Right? They move on to Bal Vihar. Yeah.
So now, basically after this, we will get into now actual experiences of conducting a class. Roma has been taking a Shishu Vihar class now for almost 2 years. And she is one of the best people to approach if you have any questions about some kind of conducting a class in any place. So she's going to share her experiences, and please feel free to just question anything that you would like. It's better that way because then we get our doubts cleared as we go along. Roma.